Good evening, ball grinders and ass slappers, and welcome to the second episode of my Let's Play of Amnesia, The Dark Descent. Let's get right into it. So, the game is running better than it did before, FPS-wise. I think it's because I had Google Chrome open last time. So, to all of you who are still here and watching the video, much appreciated. You know, you didn't totally bail on me after the failure that was the last episode. Oh, it wasn't too bad, was it? Yeah. Oh well. So, let's get things started off right by hitting the study, because we know there's good stuff in here. So for your aesthetic pleasure tonight, I have a bowl of pretzels and some water. Again, I always gotta be eating while I'm gaming, so you can hear that. Forgot how dark this game was. I'm getting some screen tearing, hold on. That's better. Not sure if you guys are able to see that, but it made me sad. So, I love how all the libraries have that strange background whirring sound to them. This is Jesus. Fuck Jesus. Wait. Wait, come on. Aha! More notes. To my most trusted student and friend, Johann Weyer. The most remarkable thing happened as I was traveling through the Prussian woods last summer. I finally found one of the orbs I've been looking for the last 20-odd years. It is as inexplicable as the Heliodromus described it in the Hortus Conclusus. It was, as it was told about, an underground Mithraic temple crowned with the unearthly artifact. The orb was big enough to fill my cupped hands, and the texture was smooth and jagged, its color washed while rich. Contrast is not enough to describe its nature. It was an impossibility, an artifact paradox captured within stone. I was staying in a nearby village called Altstadt, investigating one of the antiquated trails when I finally found the cavern. I went inside and suddenly could verify the truth of these enigmatic artifacts. They were real. As you can understand, this is one of the most important discoveries in my life, but has also become my greatest fear. As I entered the underground chamber, I could feel that I was trespassing. Because of my curiosity, I did my best to fight these instincts and fetched the orb from its place. I scrambled out of the chamber and into the woods. I could sense that something was following me. It bayed loudly as it closed in. The beast, the guardian of the orb, was relentless in its pursuit. I made my way to a nearby ravine where I stumbled upon some men fishing in a lake. I tried to warn them as I passed, but fortunately they remained as I continued my escape. When I heard their cry of pain echo through the valley, I felt such a tremendous sense of relief, thinking I would be spared. Suddenly, a blue shimmering light engulfed me, and the colors of the forest were washed away before my eyes. I kept running through the bleak surroundings. The trees had turned charcoal black with the leaves of cinder, the ground covered in murky water. I passed on through the drenched land as the glowing ember gave way to the rising wind and rained on me. I could hear pleading screams in the distance, and I joined in as pain and fear overtook me, and I fell to the ground, gasping for air. This certainly must sound strange, but I had been carried miles away across the Alps to a grassy field outside Genoa. The Guardian had taken the orb from me, but still, until this day, I fear its return. Sometimes I lie awake at night listening for the howling cry I heard in the forest. It's been nearly a decade since that day, and I still haven't been able to write about the incident. The last time we spoke, you told me about your interest and ongoing research into mythic orbs, and I realized I owed you the truth about my visit to Altstadt. Your friend and mentor, Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa. Fantastic literature. It's I said this last time, but the game really builds up some really cool plots happening and stuff. Yeah, the orbs and shadow. Makes you really want to know what this whole business is about, you know? So many tinder boxes. It's like they didn't have electricity. Oh, wait. Can we break this? Ah. Now we did. I don't think I've ever explored this. Whoa, was that a... it was like a statue of a gatherer. That would have been funny. I wonder if there's anything up here. Because I don't assume people normally go for this drawer. Nah. Thought it'd be worth a try. Oh, man, so what did I do today? Well, I slept for a while. Not long enough. Oh, was that this morning? Yeah, I had the, I did some practice. I didn't do a practice. I took the legit ACT this morning. Yeah, that was an interesting time. I'll rant about it in a second, but I really don't like the whole, standardized testing thing, you know?
Let's see what you have to offer. What a mess. I should have sharpened the saw, but I can sense it. It's definitely there.
The canine spine. So yeah, I really don't much like standardized testing. Primarily because, you know, I believe in individuality and the rest. And so when we just become a number, it's kind of like, you know, just taking away who we are and just making it equations to be fed into a machine to spit back out what your future's going to be. And I'm not cool with that. You know what I mean? I want to actually be given a damn about for who I am and not just be fed into a... Not just be fed into a system to be, you know, processed in an equation. You know, I mean, people these days care so much about the what you'll become, what you'll be doing. There's so little of the who you'll become, the things, you know, that'll aid you in who you are. Instead, it's all about, you know, are you going to be successful? You're going to get into a good college. You got to do this and this grade and that grade. And make sure you do this and make sure you do that, you know? There's so little in the way of individual self-improvement that's kind of just soullessly stripping away who we are and what matters. After a short study, it's clear that the agitation found among humans can be found in the dog. Fear and pain induce stress, which seems to trigger an endogenous response, causing the animal to burst with energy. I believe that the catalyst is produced in the brain. It's difficult to determine exactly where and what it is, but I can sense it. It reeks of cosmic genesis. There's an inherent problem in harvesting this energy, since the creature is bound to die from the exercise. I must refine this process of torture to enable any real work to be done. More experiments must be performed, but it seems that only human beings are able to produce the amount necessary. It may be their ability to appreciate the severity of the process that ultimately augments their experience of this terror. Signed, Shao Tucker. This game's so creepy. Oh, look, it's blocked. I gotta have the shit, like, knock something over, don't we? See, when I first played the part here, I didn't know what to do because, you know, up until then, all these windows weren't breakable. You know, you just couldn't touch them. Shit would bounce off. And then suddenly, you get to this point, like, I get that got cracked, so that's why you were able to do it, but I didn't observe that. I didn't know you could be like... Hell yeah. Of course, because I broke a window, I'm now crystally clear sane. Seems legit, Daniel. And now we have platforming! I love how that tree falls over. Or wherever it was. I missed it, didn't I? Oh well. It's just a cool little addition to make you feel the weight of this whole thing that's going on, the shadow or whatever. It's pretty awesome. Yeah, these archives are weird. So I have a feeling I'm going to get to the prison by tonight sometime. And I also hate the prison, so you guys will have fun with that. Here's another one of those things I don't understand. When will it be my turn? Have I not shown restraint? My patience spans centuries. For where I came, mankind has not even wasted a breath, and yet I bow to you. I have done so much for you, and I have gained nothing in return. Agrippa, I have trusted you. It was I who, in all fairness, should have entered that gate. Interesting. So, yeah, the ACT, I bitched about that, but I felt I did pretty alright on it. It had three English sections, and I'm really good, you know, literature and English stuff in general, so that was good. The math section, you know, math being my really weak point, the math section itself wasn't too bad. I felt I did alright on it. My problem was the science section. I mean, that was terrible. It was like, you know, if we're doing this experiment and I have 20 bajillion different factorets, like if this is placed in ethyl water and... breaks down again. The elevator breaks down again. Make sure you use the steam engine to build up pressure before channeling into the machinery. Adjust levers to get the right amount of pressure inside the chamber. The mirror should read up 8 and down 8. Gotta have these. Alright. Help with the puzzle. So, yeah, the science section was ridiculous. It was like, if this experiment is taking place in ethyl alcohol and they add in the, you know, the physics, and you add in this metal rod and stir it to this temperature, but then substitute this for that solution, it's pretty killer. It's like, come on, like, who's ever going to worry about that? Like, if you're going to get into that field, I can understand. But, I mean, this is just a standardized baseline test for colleges. I'm getting into digital media. When am I going to need to know that crap? Oh, well, whatever. But I also went to a black belt test today. Three martial artists from... there's that falling tree. I knew I didn't miss it. Three martial artists from where I go to train in Taekwondo. It's Master Ketchin's Martial Arts Fitness Academy. Fitness Academy was just appended onto there, and then we're all like, eh. So, but, yeah. I go there to train, and there were three people who got their black belts. It was a small test. It was three kids. One of them got his third black belt. He got one in a prior martial art. Now he's got his first degree in Taekwondo, and he's like 11. No, 12. Regardlessly impressive. It was an awesome test. The demo team did stuff. And for those who ask, I'm only a blue stripe. So it'll be another 2 years before I get my black belt. I'm working at it. The demo team that does like all the awesome martial arts stuff performed. They're really sweet.
My journal is gone. What would they want with my journal?
So yeah, this is where I feel, you know, gatherers get formally introduced is in this room. Because, you know, you have to hide in that one closet when you go in that one. Yeah, everyone knows what I'm talking about. Because everyone's already played this game before. And so the demo team performed, and it was cool stuff. I really enjoyed it. And stuff that I'm watching that, and I'm like, man, if only I was that decently talented at doing anything at all. Daniel, what do you have to say?
2nd of July, 1839. I received a letter today from the Algerian governor's office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion. The man rambled deliriously about the expedition being attacked by something horrible. The French quickly dispatched a search party to look for the expedition. After searching for days, they found the camp abandoned without any trace of Herbert or his men. Tomorrow, I'll retrieve the things they recovered from Herbert's tent at the customs house. I don't know what to make of it, but I'm worried for him.
Daniel gets worried a lot, but with good reason. I mean, look at this shit. That's all I have to say. Did we already open these? Yeah, we did. Do you like clothes? Well, we can't take it out of there. So that to be like, well, fuck your clothes, bitch. Blah. Damn. I'm never sure if I'm striking well enough balance between just talking about my life and talking about the game, so I kind of mix it up into cockroaches. And just kind of... I ramble as I do this. I'm not thinking, oh, this is the joke I'm gonna make. I just kind of make it happen, you know? So, forgive me if any of the comedy is incredibly stupid, which it most likely is. I try, I really do. Not hard, but I try. Daniel?
3rd of July, 1839. Today I picked up Herbert's things at the customs house. I dug through the trove of documents he had carried and found a log detailing the expedition. The nature of this text ranged from quick notes to colorful accounts of transpired events. I skimmed the pages, trying to figure out what might have happened. May 17th, the day I was trapped inside the orb chamber, Herbert dryly states, "Recovered Daniel after 1 hour of entrapment." This confused me greatly. I was suffocating within minutes. How could I have lasted an hour? I continued reading the peculiar text. Herbert states his facts without judgment or passion, but suddenly I could read frustration into his text. He pushed his men to investigate the underground tomb, an effort which seems to have strained the minds of his men. Madness spread through the ranks, and Herbert had to take some extreme measures to continue. He finally visits the chamber himself, where he retrieves the orb to the surface. His account confuses me greatly. If he has the orb, what are those pieces in my drawing room?
And the fiction twists. Oh look, it's an inkwell. Hey, do you like inkwells? Fuck inkwells. Oh god. This is, so I'm assuming this is where Daniel stayed. And I find it an interesting place for them to introduce the first gatherer. Stuck by a broken lock? Fuck it, we'll just go Gordon Freeman style on that bitch.
The key. Please, let it be here.
That totally didn't mean to say anything. Daniel.
4th of July, 1839. It's done. The orb is assembled. I was awakened by an exhausting nightmare. Shaking and sweating, I retired to the drawing room with a cup of tea. The relic pieces lay spread across the table as I'd left them, but somehow I knew how it was supposed to be. I fetched the tar, which I had prepared to fix the pieces together, and without fault I joined them, producing the orb I remembered so clearly. The tar proved unnecessary. It was pushed out from the joining pieces as they merged on their own, with no adhesive. The ancient stone relic now rests on my table. Its immaculate surface and perfect shape could have been molded by a factory. This is all too strange.
Yeah, and that's not the only strange thing in this game. Jesus Christ, that was a little bit earlier than I intended. You gotta give him credit for making enemies scary again in so many horror games. You know, the solution... Oh, shit! You know, the solution is always, well, you can shoot it, you can kill it. Hell, even in a terrifying level like Raven Hold'em in Half-Life, you know, you always had the ability to shoot it, shoot the zombies or whatever. This game, you ain't got jack, kid. You got whatever you can hide behind.
Oh, thank God, there it is. I guess it is a good place to hide it, then.
Not really. Hey, do you like keys? Fuck keys. Now, why would Daniel be hiding the machine room key behind a portrait in his room? This is a valid question. Again. Fantastic little twist there. Makes you wonder. I'm still having a hard time putting together the way this castle must be laid out. So I know the machine room is down that way because you have the elevator and stuff. But I think I'm gonna go here first so as to gather everything I need. I hate the storage room. For the sole reason because that's where things start to get creepy. Do I have what I need? I think I may need to hit the machine room first, actually. No, I don't. Because I know I need to be able to get the gas or some of the oil. No, what is it? I gotta make some elixir kind of thing to blow something up. Where do I get that from? Yeah, fuck it. I'll just go through here. I don't care. Terribly mind-altering choices here. How am I going to go about the linear game? Yeah, this is one where it says the darkness in here feels strange and unnatural. I believe Daniel writes that down in his journal. Yep. So can we just sit by the candles, maybe have a nice Italian dinner, and call it a night? I'm even having an extra oppressive sound to it, just to make you hate the game even more. For me, this is where the game starts getting creepy. Like, it really works on it. See, this is what I was looking for, the drill part. Because I think you, No. Ah, fuck. Very few games can actually make you be scared when you hear an enemy. So I give this game credit for doing that. I've said that before. But a single enemy, I mean, usually it's just like, oh, I can shoot this guy. Bada bing, bada boom, you know? But you got no means to defend yourself in this game. You can't do shit. And the game wants you to know that. Fantastic and simplistic design, really. Kind of goes against what a lot of games, typically modern games, do these days. It's all about being complicated and everything else. This game kind of hits it where it's at, you know? See, they took a limit off of how many tinder boxes you could hold. That's a good one. Usually I used to hold like 20 bajillion on me. Alexander, I've prepared the explosives you need for clearing the flood drain. I can't stress enough how important it is that the mixture is handled with care. Please try to tell your feather-brained servants this before you go ahead with your plans. The liquids are not by themselves explosive and should be separated to avoid further mishaps. I've arranged two large vats in the next room for your ingredients. All you need to do is mix the liquids, and you're ready to go. Agrippa. Now, I believe that third part to the drill is in one of these rooms to fully make that thing so you can squidge it in to the barrels and fill up the shit for the fuck. It was intelligent commentary, wasn't it? It's over here somewhere. There's another tinderbox. We could always use more of those, can't we? And ironically, I haven't used very many of them at all. Even though I ought to. Because the torches are a much more permanent source of light, and we don't want to waste that. Picked up some oil. That's good. Just gotta find that last piece to the drill. I think it may be in another part of this room. Possibly in here. Another tinderbox. Thank you. There it is. There we go. One, can't assemble the drill yet. You need all the parts. I guess there's another part I need. Okay. I don't know, I think I could try and start work on assembling the drill. I don't need them all at once. You know, it's not like if I try and make an omelet and I don't have the pan, I can't crack the eggs and fry them on the stove and then possibly get a pan one day when my financial situation gets better and my stove isn't the heated assholes of people sitting in the park as I cry myself to sleep every night underneath the Brooklyn Bridge. That's getting a little autobiographical there, I'm sorry. Okay, let's hit that one. The valve is rusted shut, huh? We'll see about that. Dude, that's some trippy shit. Pot be glowing and stuff. And there's this one. Rusted shut as well. God, ain't anyone ever heard of... And my drill just evaporated. Why is everything rusty in this place? Why is everything always rusty in every horror video game ever? It's like we can never have it take place in a nice, clean, comfy environment. It's always, hey, this shit's dilapidated as hell.
Please, let me go! I won't tell anyone, I swear! I just want to go home! No! Get away from me! Leave me alone!
Poor lady. I have a feeling that not nice things were done in this place. It won't budge? Don't worry, I have a key. But it's for the machine room. So, ha! I don't want it to open. What's it say? Machine parts? I got your machine parts right here, buddy. Check this shit out. This gonna go off? Do not set off the explosion till you're safely out of the blast area. Well, how am I supposed to do that? I have to touch it to set it off. Oh, I gotta chuck something at it? Like a skull or something? Oh, shit. So I guess trying to toss those barrels like I did in the past wasn't the best idea, eh? I got myself blown to smithereens so many times. I was never known for being a wise man. A wise ass, maybe. But not a wise man. It's funny that I say I'm a wise ass, because I played Bottom in Midsummer Night's Dream when my English wing performed it a couple weeks ago.
Why are you doing this? Get away from me!
Hurting my eyes again. I'm using up some of these torches just because food storage. Aw, oh, hell no. There's this one room there where a gatherer's hiding in there, and you know it is. Like I said, I will most likely die on many occasions, so laugh it up if I do. I'm not claiming to be any good at this game, I'm just playing it and having a good time. Well, as good a time as anyone can have whilst playing Amnesia, I suppose. Does anyone ever have a good time while playing this game? Or is it just an act in extended torture? I'd reckon the latter. See, there's a gatherer in that room. I'm not getting anywhere near it, as I recall from prior endeavors.
Oh God, no, please, please.
Ugh. The hell? We can touch the fire. It hurts. Why would you ever give the player the ability to touch the fire and hurt themselves? So these are the chains we've been hearing. Machine parts. Yeah, we gotta go through the torch room to get to the machine parts. What genius laid that shit out? If a full set of three rods is unavailable, there's one rod in the inner study rooms, which might work in case the elevator breaks down again. Unless it's absolutely necessary, always use the spare rods in storage before using an amended one. Well, we already have that one, so, crisis averted. Just take these. And here comes the gatherer. Days. Okay. Oh god, why does he sound like he's behind me? That would suck. I turn around, he's standing right there. That'd be terrible. So you get a headache from darkness, figure that one out. Well, I don't think sitting in the dark here is going to do us any good. Just gotta proceed. And hope not to touch these chains and piss off my vagina face. Oh shit. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. He was coming this way. So what do you think, guys? Should I book it? I don't know, running past the gatherer is kind of hard. Fuck. He's out there. And he is pissed. Well, this is turning out to be an extremely productive video, hiding behind a low wall in a storage room while we know there's a grunt out there. This is the pinnacle of entertainment, my friends. Truly. I mean, we don't even know where he is. We hear him slogging around out there. Dwell by the candle. Yeah, my head is pounding, my hands are shaking. Why? Because I sat in the dark? Like, is Daniel that afraid of the dark? I've always wondered that. Let's take another peek. See what the situation is like. Wouldn't it suck if I turned the corner and he's standing right there? Okay, we're clear. Still gotta be careful, Daniel. Doing all right. Doing all right. Just keep going. I don't know where he is. I don't want to know where he is. We can keep it just as a professional relationship. Simple as that. You don't bother me, I don't bother you. That's the way it's done in the business. I'm sure the grunt can respect that. Then again... Jesus. Then again, I technically am bothering him by entering his castle. Well, the castle he resides in. Oh, God Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. Start playing a stealth on. Hello, nice parallax textures. I am so fucked. He is going to rape my shit. Where do the gatherers go at, anyways? Like, I know, because after a while they kind of disappear. Does the game just take them out once they feel you've averted them? Do they, like, leave the map? Because I know they're, like, you know, they're scripted. They're not random encounters. When you see a gatherer, you see him for a reason. Still won't budge. Fucking, I'm getting out of here. Back to somewhere a little bit more light and familiar. The back hall. See, people do have a back hall. You know, there's a front hall, and then there's the back hall. However. Oh, not the red shit again. Really? Oh, no, it's just... Oh, yeah, there is the red shit.
Don't forget your bag, Daniel.
I won't, Herbert.
There is no shame in using a parasol in the desert. As it happens, it's imperative to your survival.
But it looks ridiculous.
The shame will hurt much less than dying, I assure you.
So, this happened. How profound. Can we still play in the water? Ow! I'll take that as a no. A wound is bleeding quite badly. Shit. Yeah, that area is blocked off, as if I wanted to go back down there again. We all remember the water monster, don't we? Okay, damn right we do. Alright. It's really hot in my room. Hence this tension.
You have an ascending room. Will it take us to the inner sanctum?
It will definitely take care of the vertical part of our journey. So, you have ridden an elevator before?
Yes, the Colosseum at Regent's Park has one. It takes you to the gallery where you can view the panorama.
Good. This ride might be a little longer, and in the other direction.
Of course, like, just like everything, this broke-ass castle, we gotta go and fix it. Because it's all broke ass in the broke ass castle. Just like everything in here is. I'm trying to prove a point that this castle is a broken ass piece of shit. Alright. I think tonight we're gonna take it through possibly to the end of the prisons. Just for your viewing pleasure.
There's nothing left. Everything's gone.
5th of July, 1839. Today, I went to the university looking for answers. I was able to sneak into Herbert's office and pick up an address book along with some relevant textbooks. Professor Taylor at the Faculty of History was very helpful, and I managed to approach the subject of the orbs. The most interesting aspect was the prevalent trace they had left in our culture. The mythic orbs may, in fact, have inspired the Globus Cruciger, which so many royal regalia holds to this day. In ancient times, the orbs were held by priests as a symbol of the sun and its power. As I was leaving, I overheard a disturbing conversation. Sir William Smith, the geologist, was killed last night. Less than a fortnight had passed since I'd asked for his expertise. I know it's silly, but I can't help feeling responsible somehow.
That's because you is, Daniel. Alright, math. Fucking math. Alright, let's light a candle here. We're gonna be here for a while. I may not take it to the prisons tonight because I'm just gonna have such a fucking hard time figuring this shit out. Let's see. Let's try that. I know it's gotta add up to 8 and 8. So. First, let's just try flipping random switches. You know, that's always worth a try, right? Yeah, well, let's see. That's 3, 5, 8, 2 sets. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be here for a while. Yeah, I don't even know. Let's see, 6 and 5 now. See, that's 6, 5, no. No. Alright, that one should be an up one, so should that. Yeah, just trying to make the smallest integer values out of these. Oh! I got it, alright. Even and stable. Let's fuck it up. Oh no, wouldn't that be funny? So, thankfully this part isn't that creepy, it's just kind of a puzzle level, if you will. Which I've solved the most difficult of all the puzzles right now, so, congrats, Kenshin. Pat's on the back for me, but it looks like I'll be heading to the prison tonight. So, fan-dubby-dozy. Ow. Ow. God damn it, Daniel, why do you suck at opening doors so bad? Let's see here, let's take this bitch. First, let's light this light here, so I can see what the hell I'm doing. Fuck that. Put that shit in. Eat it. Okay, flow cycle, so that one goes there. That one goes there, because it's Trinity. That one goes there, four phase, because... Yeah, there we go. That's right, suckas. See, this is better. They should have people play this game instead of the fucking ACT. This is a better judge of skill in life. Only 2 spare rounds left in there, yeah. Just to remind people where that third rod is, sticking it all the way in the study. Are there any other notes around there? Because the ones in here are pretty good, because it's about how Daniel's being followed by the shadow. Whatever it is. I'm still a bit in the dark, as you all know. Well, Daniel, what do you have to say?
14th of July, 1839. I've read every book I can find on the subject. While rich in legend and hearsay, my knowledge is lack for the insight I crave. I've sent letters to many in Herbert's address book and received answers of varying importance. Today, I got one which differed greatly from the others. From a baron in Prussia. He said nothing about the quaint stories of priests in underground temples. He didn't even mention them. He simply wrote, "I know. I can protect you. Come to Brennenburg Castle." Signed, Alexander.
Pause.
What am
magic
I to
map.
Make of this? Protect me from what? Is someone after me? I looked up Brennenburg and traced it to the Prussian woods near the Baltic Sea. While being the least informative letter I've received, it causes me greatest distress and interest. As I write, my thoughts are drawn to my nightmares in which a most disturbing sound calls to me. A sound defying description. A voice from the void. The last few weeks have been awful, with so many sleepless nights dreading a repeat of those horrid dreams. Tomorrow, I shall visit my physician Dr. Tate, in hope that he can provide me with sedatives to help me sleep.
Dr. Potato Head. So let's light another light up in here. And let's see here. So light another one here. We have tinder boxes to burn. Not a worry. I have a device to make all well. Cogwheel doesn't fit there. Yeah, well, it fits there, bitch. Well, I gotta go back and haul all of them up here, like the ones I threw around, like a smartass. Fuck. Like, oh, I don't need these, it's just physics objects. No, asshole, you need them. God damn it. Cut. You have a very strange way of carrying things, Daniel. Let's see, and here! No? Okay. And here! Those cogs use the force. That's the only solution. No, there's another one up here. Is it in here? No.
The flicker. The village light.
See, this version that I have, the 1.1.1 or whatever it is, adds in a whole bunch of those extra sound clips to make the game just a little more creepy, which is appreciative, I suppose. Let's see, let's chuck it again. No? How about, That's what I thought. The machinery needs more work. I know, I was just checking it to make sure that all happened. All that was banging in there. Open up, goddammit. That's what I thought. I filled almost all the lantern oil? Fuck yeah. There should be another note somewhere in here, possibly. If not, I would be saddened. Let's haul some coal out of here. And, feel like some badasses. Manual labor. Daniel has no time for this kind of shit. He also sucks at throwing. Daniel's not a part of the manual labor workforce or the Major League Baseball team. That's why Daniel has gone to Castle Brennenburg, because all people who suck go to Castle Brennenburg. Like Alex Brennenburg. It's now full of coal. Come on, I'm trying to close this thing. Fire, bitches! Bada boom! That's right, Sally. There's gotta be a third note around here somewhere that Daniel wrote. Oh great, red shit, steak shit. Fantastic. If I didn't need enough reason to- fuck! As if the game didn't give you enough reason to hate the shadow or whatever it is. Here it is.
17th of July, 1839. How has this escaped me? They're all dead. Limbs scattered, heads split down the middle, their skin flayed as if boiled. I feel like I'm falling into myself. What's happening? Sir William Smith, Professor Taylor, now Dr. Tate. Is it following me? How can it not be? It's the damn thing I brought from Africa. Something is after me. I have no choice but to trust the Baron. He better know what he claims. If he is wrong, I suspect he'll regret it as well.
And that's the... We can go and take the elevator and go down to the prison, which is another level I hate. We'll end on that just for you all. God damn it, why do I keep getting hurt from that? It's not acceptable. Ow! Fuck! It's unnecessary. You can't even avoid it. God. What? steak shit is growing. It's gonna force us down the elevator. Let me heal myself first. Because wound is bleeding quite badly. A few cuts and bruises, we're feeling better. So let's get out of here. You all are going to love this. And I'm gonna hate it. Do 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 I did it, did it, do, but it did it, but it did it, but it did do. But it did it, but do. Thank you for choosing Elevator Incorporated. You're welcome. That sucked. Now we're in the prisons. If I recall correctly.
Come this way.
What was that?
Forgive me, I should have warned you. One of my responsibilities as a baron is that of a prison warden. This is where criminals are locked up.
Like a dungeon?
Very much so. Come, don't linger.
Why are these candles lit? I never realized that. That's very worrying. Daniel fucking Thor in here, lifting shit like a boss. Oh, you need me to move that more out of the way? How particular do you have to be? They're happy. Alright. Let me, alright. Jesus Christ, is that Big Daddy in there or something? I hate the prisons. I hate the prisons. Did I tell you guys I hate the prisons? It's just so fucking creepy. God. Even with the lights on, it makes my dick curl up in sadness. Well, no, the lights on the prison, not in the room. I'm not playing with the lights on. What do you think I am, a pussy? I'm not like PewDiePie. Oh, burn. Let's see what's good in here, huh? All these cell doors are open, so any prisoner who fucking rotted in here, that's their fault. All the cell doors are blatantly open. Got no pity for anyone who rotted in here. You can just walk right out. Fucking idiots. Hammer. Was it MC Hammer? I hope so. That's the brute in there, I think. Can't open that door, but that makes you ponder, why would you ever want to? Well, because we're stupid. That's one. Ah, fuck. Ah, shit, 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 fuck. Shit. Dicks. Goddamn. Fuck, 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 fuck. Ah, fuck, shit, fuck, shit. You have to carry him. Yeah, I know. That sucked. I've never been able to escape from that grunt. Hold on. Good thing he goes away. Like, after you use up a gatherer scare, they stay away. Which is good. I don't think I could deal with another one of those. Constantly patrolling the level. Lantern oil, how we doing there? That's good, man. I hear someone taking a chiropractor exam. A robust padlock in good shape? Oh, fuck. Banging won't do us no good. It's just so dark in here. That's why I hate it. Again, anyone who didn't escape here is a fucking idiot.
But mother, I don't want to leave without you.
Hurry, John. You must go. Find Gabriel, the Outrider, and tell him to alert the King's men.
No, you come too.
Please, we don't have time to make the hole any wider.
But...
someone is coming. Hurry, I'll cover the hole with the bed. Everything will be fine, I promise.
Newsflash, everybody. Alexander Brandenburg was a dick. Imprisoning innocent people. Now, someone sounded like he was having a good time. It wasn't where this was porno prison. Oh, what if we walked into one of those, like, fetish dungeons, like, when we played Mental Hospital? That would be worrying. That would convince me that so many people are into that shit, that... what if all horror game developers were into that, and this is them reflecting their own fantasies? Jesus. Very corroded and weak? Haha! Something else is needed, so I just can't smash it to death with a hammer? That's not fun. It should always be a solution. And again, what? Shit? How is that? Is that real? Oh, shit! Oh, shit. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. Where am I? I'm back here. Great. Well, if he comes looking for me, I'm at a dead end. The way he came in was freaky. It was like the hallway was flashing. Never seen that before. I don't want to see it again either. Kind of going insane here, Daniel. Dot, dot, dot. What was up with that? Let's go back to where he came from. Yeah, it came from here. It's the entrance to the level, isn't it? Yeah, cell area 1. That's weird. Alright. Have we been over here? I can't even tell anymore. Yeah, that's where the hammer was. Maybe stared at him a bit too long. Now we're all a bit nuts. Fuck. Can't forget your torch. Corroded and weak lock. Alright.
Where is she? Where did she go?
No! Oh, tell! I'll never tell you!
You're just making things worse. Look. This is no place for a young girl all by herself. She could be hurt or worse. There's no telling what horrors await down there.
And then you see that Daniel was a bit of an ass. Still is, probably. Oh, there we are. Picked up Chipper. We're feeling mighty chipper today, aren't we? Alright, so... hammer and Chipper. Ba-boom. And what does that get us? Few drops of oil. Get some sanity back. And not much else. We'll have those tools for the future. So I suppose that's a plus. What the fuck? That was just weird. let's hop down here. Hole is too narrow to slip through. Fuck you, look what I got. Alright, I'll still finish off this prison section for you guys. Because I know you gotta make the chemical and everything. There's this whole second section that I hate as well. Because you gotta crawl through these tunnels and it's like you're inside of a fucking sarlacc and everyone hates it. This game is fantastic, by the way. Yeah. It's just ultra claustrophobia. I'm not claustrophobic, but if I was in this situation, I'd be freaking out. I mean, come on, it's really uncomfortable. Fuck your shit. Come on. Get on with it. Kitchen, huh? Let's visit the kitchen, see if we can get some food. Who doesn't love food? Throw that door open wide like a bitch.
2nd of August, 1839. I have arrived at the village of Altstadt. It's a haven in the midst of a vast forest and the last stop before my final destination, Castle Brennenburg. It's late in the evening, and the outrider, who has been with the coach since Bremen, advised me to wait until morning before I venture further. I've arranged for a bed at Der Mühle, the village's only inn, and am now waiting for the sun to rise. I try to sleep, but as I close my eyes, I see the men who fell victim in London. My fear and shame forces me to witness the same scenes over and over. They are dead because of me.
That's heavy, Daniel. Well, it's true when you realize that, but he feels guilty over something he had no control over, so fuck that plight. But I can understand why he feels the way he does. Hell yeah, some tinderboxes. Got some bacon, alright, so can I just take this with me? Alright. Aw, sweet. Yo, dude, check this out. Meat physics. Feel like meat ping pong. Ba-da-ba-ba. This will gross any vegetarians out. If you're a vegetarian, you shouldn't be watching my videos. Fuck you. You're not worth my time. Yo, dude, can I, like, dip this thing in there? Holy shit! I didn't know I could. Can we, like, dip part of that in there, too? Like, stick a leg in? Oh, no. Dude, what if we, like, disintegrate this whole fucking kitchen? Fuck this kitchen. We're gonna disintegrate it. Let's see here. What happens if I put this in there? I kinda actually have to get in there for it to do anything. This is entirely too enjoyable. Who has a disintegrating pot in their kitchen? What? I was gonna just stick it in, you know, the, Ow. Why would you touch it, Daniel? I don't have the thing for the shit. Ow! I was just trying to investigate it, Daniel. I didn't mean for you to actually touch that damn thing. Need to find something to stick it in. What if I, like, put a box in there? What would that do? Wow, that's intense. Yo, dude, can I pick up this mouse? Nah, that would have been awesome. So we gotta find something to ship that in. To Tumblr! Because, you know, Tumblr is the place where we ship everything. Ow. Why does it let me touch this shit if it's going to hurt me? It's like, oh, touch it? Oh, you're not gonna hurt it. Oh, fuck you, you're gonna get hurt. Alright, so we gotta find something to carry that in. Let's look around this way. Now you put more piss in the shit. Ah, fuck. Ah, fuck. Ah, fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck. Fucking ass. I got nothing. Come on, Mr. Grunt, let me escape. What are you gonna do now, huh? You ain't got nothing on me. I'm just going to stand over here and shit on the apples and not look at you. Is he seriously going to leave me alone? Dude, that grunt just left me alone after slicing me and seeing me, but let me live because I sat on a table. Well, I sat at the table. Maybe these grunts are just, you know, real sticklers for good manners. If that's the case, then, you know, it's not too bad then. Oh, shit. He didn't actually leave. Why are you breaking down that door? It's right there. You just go through it. Do you have any common decency? Can't touch this. Bitch ass. Ah, okay, I won't look at you. I'm sorry. Oh god, that shadow. What do? Oh god. Okay, I won't look at you, I promise. I'm sorry, just look at the floor. I will look at the floor. Will that make you happy, sir? Oh Jesus. This is terrifying. Save me. Fuck. Well, that sucked. Oh, now there's roaches growing all over my vision because I'm crazy, technically. God damn it, Daniel. Where did I spawn? Dude, where's my car? You're shitting me. Kitchen. So is this where I came in? Oh no, I came in somewhere. There, okay. So this is the way we are off to go to the Receptacle Ketchum. Yeah, that place. But at least my wounds are healed after dying. Such is life. Death heals all wounds. That was deep. You guys should subscribe to me because I'm deep. Help you? Nah, fuck you, you're stoned. Receptalepidotelaborium. Let's go the opposite way because we can. What's new in here? I hear things flying around. That guy died. If only you could pick up and play with dead bodies like this was Bioshock. With the telecon. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
Anybody, help!
Christ, I don't believe this.
Why? I mean, why? What did I do to deserve this? I mean, it can't be. Do I deserve this? It wasn't my fault. Why did he have to go in there? Don't go into burning houses. He should have known better.
Damn, those bright lights hurt.
3rd of August, 1839. I feel like I have fled the world and all its worries. Brandenburg is a majestic creation perched upon a forest-clad hill with towers reaching well above even the highest pine trees. Following the winding road leading to the gates gives the impression of discovering something forgotten, as if journeying with Marco Polo to the hidden Xanadu. Alexander, the Baron, is a peculiar but gracious man. He seems well-versed in worldly matters and is not at all as eccentric as I assumed. My room is exquisite, and I'm confident that no hotel for miles could even hope to match it. As the sun sets on Brandenburg, its fairy tale varnish turns to an eerie gloom. Alexander's strange servants are never far away. They are a quiet lot, and their behavior could only be described as skulking. Alexander seems pleased by my presence. As he puts it, it seems like I got here just in time.
So I'm guessing the gatherers and grunts and stuff are like the servants and stuff. It's because they kind of skulk around as it is. So that's pretty neat. Fuck. I didn't mean to say that. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. If only you could extinguish candles in this game, that would help a lot. So can I... trying to haul this up and block the doorway with it. Where's the lovely gatherer man at? I know you're here, Gathy. You don't scare me. Actually, yeah, he does. Freaks me out, actually.
Is he safe? Well, it's for his own good. Soon we'll be ready.
God damn it, Daniel. Get together, Daniel.
4th of August, 1839. The nightmares woke me in the early morning, and for a moment, I forgot where I was. Shortly after, there was a knock on my door. Alexander had heard my screams and asked me to join him in the parlor. As we drank our tea, Alexander began... I said I didn't care about its powers.
Sorry, I accidentally clicked and messed that one up. I usually mute my mic during it so you guys can hear it, so that's, what? Oh, okay. That's what... listen to that again. Oh, man, we can't have it read. I'm sorry. I'll read it to you guys. As we drank our tea, Alexander began to tell me what he knew. It seems like the orb I found casts a long and dark shadow. It is not only a powerful item, but a dangerous one. Simply by touching it, you invoke the powers within, and if you are too weak to control it, it will devour you. The shadow is a sluggish thing lagging behind the wielder, killing anyone or anything in its path to reclaim the orb. I said I didn't care about its powers, and I should throw it away. Alexander advised against this, as I would still be a part of the path to the orb and eventually suffer death. Having the orb, I would at least have the chance to fight back when the time came. I asked Alexander what he meant when he said he could protect me, and he answered things can be done, but at a price. And that...
he escaped. Where is he now?
And that, my friends, is good old American capitalism. Sure, I'll help save your life, but only if you pay me. Fuck. That worked, just close the door on him. Oh, shit. I guess he didn't like that. He's getting sick of being thrown closed behind doors. I can understand that. You know what I mean? I hate it too. I'm just walking along, someone slams the door in my face randomly out of nowhere. It kind of hurts. you know? Hurts my feelings a lot. You know, so I sympathize highly, in fact. Let's see if we can sneak over here. See what there is to see. Oil could always a plus. More piss for the shit, as always. So that's all that was in here. Alright. Right now, if I recall correctly, we're looking for a holder for the acid. And that's what we find there. Sweet. You ever need someone to hold your acid? I just kind of take it, you know. Glass jar. Yes, because glass definitely won't decay in the presence of acid. Really fucking genius, Daniel. Fuck. So if I just gun it, you think I'm gonna run into him? Oh yeah. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. Fuck. How am I still alive?
Hey, you! Stop!
Don't come any closer! I just wanna leave!
You can't go outside! It's too dangerous!
Telling Gabriel!
I doubt that very much.
Well, that was odd. Ah, shit. I'm just gonna try and book it. That's why I hate these prisons, because just gotta run and hope you'll not make a terribly bad turn and suffer a dreadful fate. Like I most likely will. Fuck. Shit. Shit. I suck at this game. Yeah. Why are there unopenable doors? I mean, can I like bang it down or something? No. Right. So I could open that one door with the needle. Can't with that one. Alright, we gotta find the kitchen. Let's follow the signs this time. Because, you know, sometimes reading signs helps. I mean, I know when us men drive, we don't pay attention to road signs. But sometimes, you know, they help. Oh, you see that says 60 miles an hour? Fuck it. Go 120. It's only an approximation anyways, right? Kind of like how when you die, you kind of die, but not really. At least if you're playing Amnesia. Kitchen, that's where we're trying to go. Now where to? This way, but yeah, we can't go the other way. Durr. I died right around here, so I never got to discover the beautiful stuff that there is to discover. It's the disembodied voices that kind of creep me out. What? You're shitting me. I don't care, I have a bottle of acid. Get to like chuck it at the gatherer. Fuck. See if I can use it on him. Oh shit, no object to use item on. You can use it on that gatherer. It's bullshit. You're lying to me, game. God damn it, game. Carry on my wayward son. Fuck, what am I supposed to do now? Where am I? In the tunnels again. God damn it. Steak shit's growing. Guess the game's kind of kicking me out. Let's see here. Won't budge. How about some acid? No? Okay. How about some acid? It would. Alright, well, how about some of this? It would do no good. Only on certain ones, huh? Fine. I really just want out of this underground area and get to something a little nicer. I don't even know what's next, but I know it's better than here. Anything's better than here. Well, except for the water level. That water level that everyone fucking hates. With the Karenek. That's what they call the Karenek. Yeah, my torch is probably nearly done for. It's a cistern entrance. Oh, we're nearing where I basically got before I played. Let's see, let's dump the acid on there. And watch the fireworks. Holy shit. Very poor condition. Well, fuck your shit. Break it off. Severely weaken the padlock. Well, fuck you, we're gonna add insult to injury. Oh god. I'm not sticking around. Alright, yeah, this is close to where I was last time. Oh, flashback, man.
So you used the drain sewers as a means of transport?
Yes, they were built to divert water from an underground spring, and are quite spacious. It seemed only natural to incorporate it into the overall structure.
But we won't be using it.
Not today. The flow is seasonal, and when the spring runs dry, the damp tunnels produce a rather poisonous type of fungi. There is an antidote, of course, but we won't be bothering with it today. Come, this way instead. We're almost there.
So yeah, I got mainly to this part. I got to the part we're actually in, like, that whole water area, and you hallucinate and see the Karenek again. So I think this is a good place to leave off and pick it up tomorrow or whenever I next choose to play the game. I hope you guys enjoyed this one as much as you enjoyed the last one or more. I don't know if it was any good, but I gave it a try. So thanks for coming out, thanks for watching, and have a lovely day. I love you all. Peace.